Producer's equilibrium. Firm is in equilibrium when it maximizes its profit. Maximum profit is possible when total revenue is greater than total cost. We shall first understand the revenue behavior of a firm. In this graph, total revenue, total cost, and profit are measured along the y-axis. Output along the x-axis. Total revenue curve slopes positively upwards. LB is the total revenue from the sale of OL output. MC revenue is from the sale of OM quantity. The sale of ON units brings the total revenue of ND amount. Larger the output sold, more is the inflow of total revenue. So, the total revenue curve is one of upward sloping. The curve has a uniform slope because the firm sells its output at the same price. Look at the table. The price remains the same at Rs. 10. We assume perfect competition. The total revenue goes on increasing. Let us understand the total cost curve. It is inverted S-shaped curve. It starts at A along the y-axis. OA is the fixed cost. In the beginning, the law of diminishing cost operates. So the curve is concave downwards. And then it is concave upwards. This is due to law of increasing cost. Vertical distance is the total cost. ME is the total cost of OM output. We shall superimpose the total revenue curve on the same graph. We have both revenue and cost curves. For the firm to be in equilibrium, it has to earn maximum profit, we know. The vertical distance between total revenue and total cost gives the profit for any given level of output. When OL output is produced, total cost is equal to total revenue. Total cost is LB. Total revenue is also LB. To the left of output L, the producer cannot get any profit. In this region, total cost is greater than total revenue. The firm will incur loss. Similarly, when ON output is produced, total cost is equal to total revenue. Total cost is ND. Total revenue is also ND. Again, the firm will not operate beyond the output N. To the right of this output, total cost is greater than total revenue. The firm will operate in the region LN. Only in this range, total revenue is greater than total cost. As he moves up from output L to N, the difference between total revenue and total cost widens and then becomes narrow. The total profit increases and then decreases. So, in this range, there is one level of output for which the difference between total revenue and total cost is maximum. I mean, the profit is maximum. It is at OM level of output, the difference between total revenue and total cost is maximum. MC is the total revenue, ME is the total cost, EC is the profit. This is the maximum profit. If you draw a tangent to total cost curve at point E, it will be parallel to the total revenue curve. You must understand, no other output will bring more profit than EC. For better understanding, we shall plot the profit curve also. That segment of the profit curve that is to the left of L lies below the x-axis. It denotes negative profit. Again, that segment which is to the right of N also lies below the x-axis. Again, it signifies negative profit. Only that segment which is between L and N lies above the x-axis. It means profit is positive. Profit increases and then decreases. Only at output M, profit is maximum. The producer is in equilibrium.